If you're closing your hot tub up for the winter, it's not as easy as just putting the cover on and walking away. Freezing temperatures can do significant damage to your spa, particularly the plumbing lines. Now, winterizing your hot tub the right way will save you time and money in the long run. So here are 11 steps to winterizing your hot tub. Check it out. First, when should you winterize your hot tub? If your hot tub's outside in an environment that drops below freezing and you don't plan to run it and use it consistently all winter long, then you'll need to winterize your hot tub. Now, regardless of where your hot tub is located, anytime you plan on not using your spa for an extended period of time, like a month or more, you'll want to close your hot tub following these steps. So here's how to winterize your hot tub. Before you begin, you'll need a few supplies. You'll want a sump pump, a garden hose, a shop vac, a hot tub filter cleaner, a spa filter soak, a hot tub cleaner, hot tub cover cleaner, non-abrasive sponges, and soft cloths or towels. Step number one, let the chemicals dissipate. Before you drain all the water out of your hot tub and into your yard or other location, you'll need to let the chemical levels drop. Now give it a few days and test the water. Once the chlorine or other sanitizer level has dropped to zero, you can begin to winterize your hot tub. Step number two, turn off the breaker. It's not enough to just turn off the hot tub. You want to make absolutely sure that there is no power getting to your hot tub. You can also simply unplug it if it's not hardwired. Do not skip this step. Electricity and water do not mix, and failing to cut the power to your hot tub will put you and anyone else who may be helping you in danger during this process. Remember, safety first, always. Step number three, drain the hot tub. Remove the drain cap and attach a garden hose to the drain spout. Make sure the other end of the hose is in an appropriate place to drain all the water. You'll be releasing roughly 400 gallons of water or more, and make sure that the drainage area can accommodate that amount. If you want to drain your spa more quickly, you can pump the water out with a sump pump. Keep an eye on your hot tub so the pump doesn't run dry. Also, remember to move the drain cap when you're done using the pump. An inch or two of water will remain at the bottom of the hot tub, but you don't have to worry about that right now. Step number four, drain the blower. If your hot tub has an air blower, you have to drain the water from it before continuing. First, turn off the heater. Never run the heater when the hot tub is empty, so make sure that the switch is in the off position. Two, cover the hot tub. Put a hard cover in place just as you normally would. Three, turn the breaker on. Four, turn the hot tub on, and this will run the blower. Let it run for about 30 seconds to remove any water from inside. Five, turn off the hot tub. Six, turn off the breaker, or just unplug the hot tub. And seven, remove the cover, and then get back to winterizing your hot tub. Step number five, loosen the unions on the pumps and heater. Open the access panel in the cabinet and locate the pump or pumps and heater. Loosen the unions to allow water to drain from the plumbing lines. If the pump has a drain plug, remove that as well and allow any water inside the pump to drain out. Before we continue, if you're looking for an easy-to-follow tutorial that'll answer all your hot tub questions, go check out our hot tub handbook and video course. Step number six, remove and clean the filters. You don't want to leave filters in place over the winter. You also don't want to store dirty filters. So remove them and take this opportunity to clean them. Since you'll be storing your filter for weeks, possibly months, we recommend putting them in a chemical soak for 24 hours or at least overnight before storing them. If the filters are beyond cleaning, toss them out and start with new filters when you open your hot tub up next season. Once you've removed the filter or filters, remove any water that's left in the filter well. You can do this with a shop vac, sponges, or towels. Step number seven, blow out the lines. Leaving water in the plumbing lines over the winter can cause the water to freeze and expand, which can cause the lines to crack or burst. You want your hot tub to be completely empty of water over the winter. Now this is where the shop vac comes in. Turn the shop vac setting to blow and insert the hose into every drain, union, and jet, and the filter cavity. Blow into each spot for about 10 to 15 seconds to force the water out of the lines and into the tub. When you're finished, Repeat this process. Again, you don't want any water in the lines. Step number 8, remove the remaining water. Now, depending on how much water is now in the hot tub after blowing out the lines, you may want to use the sump pump again and then use the shop vac to pull out whatever the pump can't get. Now, if it's just a little water, the shop vac should be able to handle it all. Step number 9, clean the shell. Use non-abrasive sponges and a hot tub cleaner that doesn't require rinsing to clean the shell. You can also use household products like white vinegar and baking soda. If you find a ring of hot tub scum where the water line was, you may need to soak it a bit with some hot tub cleaner before scrubbing it away. You may also want to use a little diluted bleach to kill any bacteria that may be hiding in it. Step number 10, clean the cover. Since you're winterizing your hot tub and keeping it closed for a few months, the cover needs to be clean. If the hot tub is outside, use a good cover cleaner that's also a protectant to shield the cover from the sun's rays. Clean the underside, the top, and the sides, getting into all of the crevices created by seams. Let it air dry or wipe it dry with a towel. You don't want to close up any moisture when you cover your hot tub. Step number 11, secure the cover. Once the cover's dry, place it over your spa. If it locks, lock it to prevent anyone or anything from climbing into the hot tub during the winter. Now, even if your hot tub cover locks, it's a good idea to secure it further with wind straps to ensure it stays put through the toughest winter storms. Finally, before we wrap up, can you put antifreeze into a hot tub? Sometimes it's not a question of can, but a question of should. Well, you shouldn't have to. If you've properly winterized your hot tub, blowing out the lines and removing every last drop of water from every inch of the spa, then there is no need for antifreeze. And that's it. That's how to winterize your hot tub. If you missed anything or have any questions, please leave a comment to let us know. Hit the like button below if you found this video helpful. And if you want to learn more about hot tub maintenance and troubleshooting, subscribe to our channel and check out the Hot Tub Handbook and Video Course at swimuniversity.com/spa. Don't forget to enter that promo code VIDEO to get 10% off. That's it. Thanks again and happy soaking.